This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello once again, welcome to episode 17. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to find the difference quotient of a function. Let's get started. Our problem today is to find the difference quotient of the function 2x squared plus 3. In your book, you may have seen a certain equation for the difference quotient, and it probably went like this. F of x plus h minus f of x, and then divide by h. Now, if you try to do all of this at once, you could get lost pretty quickly. So I don't recommend you try to do everything at the same time. I recommend that you do this in three steps. In the first step, find what f of x plus h is and simplify it as much as possible. In the second step, subtract your original f of x from that. And in your third step, divide the whole thing by h. Let's go ahead and give this a try. So our first step is going to be to find the value of f of x plus h, and then try to simplify it as much as possible. Okay? When I say to find f of x plus h, I mean to replace our x in the original function with the quantity x plus h. All right? So instead of having 2x squared plus 3, we will now have 2, the quantity x plus h squared, plus 3. Now, I don't much like having parentheses in the way while I'm trying to do all this other stuff to it. So you should probably, at this point, try to FOIL it out and get rid of the parentheses eventually. When we do that, we're going to rewrite it as 2 times x plus h times x plus h plus 3. And now I'll go ahead and FOIL it. So I will multiply the x times the h times the x, and the h times the h. I'm going to leave the 2 on the outside, though. X times x is x squared. X times h is xh. H times x is also xh. And then h times h is h squared, close parentheses, and then put the 3 on the outside. Once you've done that, it's probably a good idea to check for any terms that you can combine. Well, we have two xh's there, so it would be a good idea to combine those. So I'll just rewrite it here. 2 times x squared plus, well, xh and xh makes 2xh plus h squared plus 3 on the outside. Then, after I've done all of this, I'll just multiply the 2 into all three of the terms. So we'll have 2 times x squared, 2 times 2xh, 2 times h squared. This will give me 2x squared plus 4xh plus 2h squared plus 3, and that is the end of the first step. Now that I know what f of x plus h is, my second step will be to subtract the original f of x from that. Alright. So, we're going to put a little minus sign down here, and we're going to subtract the 2x squared. Make sure you put it underneath the terms that match up with it. And we're also going to subtract the positive 3 to give us minus 3. So, the 2x squared and the minus 2x squared cancel. The 3 and the negative 3 cancel. Leaves us with only two terms. 4xh plus 2h squared. Now that I'm on the second step, my third step is going to be to divide by h. But before I can divide by h, I have to factor out h first. Once I've factored the h out, then it will be much easier to divide by h. So let's try to factor h out of both of those. Well, I've got an h term here and an h term here. Let's just divide both of these terms by h and then put a parenthesis here. All right, since my goal is to factor out h, I'm going to write h on the outside. And then we'll say 4xh divided by h is 4x. And then 2h squared divided divided by h gives us 2h. We'll put a little positive sign there in the middle. Now that I've factored out h, it's okay to go ahead and divide by h. Well, the h on the top and the h on the bottom cancel out. And so my answer is simply 4x plus 2h. And there you have it. That's the difference quotient. This can get a little bit more involved when you start messing around with fractions. We're going to do another one of those next episode. We'll see you there.